Hi, I'm Paul Torgerson. It's Tuesday, December 10th, 2019, and this is a look at the information security news from overnight. From ZDNet, the Ryuk ransomware decryptor has a bug that will make some files unretrievable even if you have paid the ransom. The decryptor cuts one byte from the end of each file it decrypts. In most files, that byte is a buffer and it being trimmed has no impact. However, some files use that last byte, making them permanently corrupted. You should back up your encrypted files before using the application. From Bleeping Computer, a new Snatch ransomware strain reboots Windows computers into safe mode. This automatically disables most security solutions that the system may have in place. Once the system loads, it can get to work encrypting your files. There's more details in the article. From ThreatPost, marketing firm IPR Software left an Amazon S3 database exposed without a password, likely since it was uploaded in 2017. In all, over a terabyte of information on thousands of customers, including GE, Dunkin' Donuts, Forever 21, just to name a few. After first being notified at the end of October, it took the company over a month to finally secure the database. From TechCrunch, an online company that allows users to obtain copies of their birth and death certificates has also left an AWS database unsecured. More than 752,000 applications for copies of birth certificates and over 90,000 death certificate applications have been left out in the open. We are not calling out the name of the company because despite having been notified several times by several entities, that sucker is still sitting there unprotected. And last today, from SC Magazine, the city of Pensacola, Florida can't catch a break. Less than a day after the deadly shooting at Pensacola Naval Air Station, a cyber attack has forced the city to shut down many of its systems. It is thought to be a ransomware attack, but that is unconfirmed at this time. It is also too soon to know if this attack is in any way related to the shooting. While many phone and online systems are down, the city stressed that the 911 service has not been impacted. That's all for me today. Have a great rest of your day, and until tomorrow, be safe out there.